What's going on, everybody? Nash Tyler Harrington with Con TV, hanging out here in downtown Los Angeles, California for the Electronic Entertainment Expo, E3, baby. I am excited because right now I'm in my happy place. I'm at the PlayStation booth, and most of you know that's my favorite console. So let's go. I'm ready to hang out. PlayStation started off E3 2016 strong with a press conference that featured a live orchestra and a full house, all ready for quite the special surprise.
Your mother's knife. It belongs to you now.
What for?
A test. She taught you to hunt, yes?
Yes, sir.
Then show me what you know. I am hungry. Feed us.
Suffice to say, people were pretty excited when Kratos walked out of the shadows. Now, we don't know a whole lot about the storyline of this game, but it appears in this footage that Kratos has become a bit of a mentor with a young apprentice. We don't know if this is a son or maybe more of a metaphorical son. My guess is it's probably more the metaphorical son. That he's teaching this kid how to become a man. The other question is are we going to play as Kratos through this game or possibly play as this child throughout portions of the game? A lot of times when they show this gameplay at a convention, it's even gameplay that may or may not show up in the final version of the game. So a lot of questions there. A couple really cool things that I can take away from this footage is, one, it appears that the majority of the game is going to be played in third person. In the past, if my memory serves me correct, we really only played some of the boss fights in third person, and the rest of the game was in more of that aerial ARPG view. So I'm actually pretty excited about the third person style. And it also appears that this rumors have been confirmed that we are playing Norse mythology. Again, it appears that Kratos is teaching this young child how to become a man, how to hunt, how to recognize that sometimes you do have to take life to survive yourself. So it'll be interesting to see how much of this apprentice-mentor storyline plays into the full storyline of the next God of War installment. All I can say is I'm excited to get my hands on it. I can't wait to sink my teeth into some more God of War. Horizon Zero Dawn. Now, this is one of the new titles that I am really excited about. It's exclusive to PlayStation, and it's set in a post-apocalyptic Earth, 1,000 years into the future, where humans are scarce, and the world is overrun by these mechanized robot dinosaurs, and who knows what else. We get to play as this character, a young tribeswoman, Aloy. She's trying to figure out where she came from and find answers as to why Earth is the way that it is now. I'm gonna go ahead and shut up so that we can take a look at some of the beautiful gameplay we can expect once we get our hands on Horizon Zero Dawn.
Got some weak spots.
Watch out! It's corrupted! I came from Mother's Rise.
Corrupted attacked the village. Yes, and something worse. A demon.
What do you mean, a demon?
It scuttled from the forest. Drove a group of watchers mad.
How did it do that?
I saw, but I did not understand. Oh, goddess, protect us!
Keep running for Mother's Crown. It's not far.
Come with me, or the demon will kill you.
I don't believe in demons, and I don't run when lives are at stake. Get out of here.
You're crazy!
It looks ancient. Where did it come from?
PlayStation VR. This was by far the coolest thing that I saw at all of E3 2016. It's pretty straightforward. It's a VR headset that's compatible with your PlayStation 4. Now, I admit a number of the games they were testing out at E3 were a bit gimmicky, though they were still fun. As you will see from the game I had the chance to try out, Headmaster. It's basically a video game where you head soccer balls into a net, which doesn't sound that exciting, but the positive takeaway from this was that the mechanics were very intricate. As you'll see here when I'm heading soccer balls to the side, with every minute flick of my head, a different type of English will be put on the ball. And what that tells me is that the mechanics are very, very intricate. And that's a huge positive in my mind because it means that these games are going to be very intuitive. And the other big takeaway is that big intellectual properties are already developing games like Batman Arkham VR and Resident Evil 7, which will have a VR playable version when it hits the shelves. The most exciting part about all this, PlayStation VR will be available October 2016.
Because it's a very strong drug and highly addictive.
PlayStation.